Hi there, and welcome to Meet the Leaders. We are in Albany, and I'm David Smith. Great to have you along with us today. Kicking off a new session in Albany. It's going to be a very, very busy year. There's no question about it. And we are pleased to have one of the guys who is going to be very heavily involved in some of the intricacies of this year here in Albany, Assemblyman Mike Benedetto of the 82nd District from the Bronx. It's great to see you, Assemblyman. How are you?
David, I'm doing well, and thank you for having me here.
Well, you all prep for an involved session, no question about it.
It's going to be an extremely interesting, maybe the most interesting in the last 10 years or so. The whole dynamic up here in the state capitol has changed with the Democrats taking over in the state Senate, and we in the assembly are eagerly looking forward to a new partnership with people who are basically like-minded. So we're going to see where that goes.
Well, you have recently been named to head up the education component of this whole endeavor, and that is truly a major undertaking.
It's a bit daunting. I'm very honored with the fact that I have been appointed by Speaker Hasty to head the Education Committee. I was a teacher for 35 years. I still consider myself a teacher at heart, even though I've been here now 14 years up in Albany. And this is kind of, the culmination of a long career. So it's a great honor, and I'm looking forward to doing some good things.
Well, as you take a look at the education systems, because it's not just one system, there are a multitude of systems that
there
you
are about in. 700 school districts in the state of New York, an enormous number.
And there are intricacies of each one and others as well.
That's correct. And little nuances, just like in teaching.
Yeah.
Every child is different and very nuanced in how you approach them.
Well, where are you starting your focus? What are you looking at first and foremost as you get underway?
Well, there are many issues in the education sphere, one of which is the evaluation of teachers. This is a debate that's been going on for the last 6-7 years now, and I think it will come to a head in this session, and I think it will come to a head very, very quickly. I think we'll be looking to finally resolve teacher evaluations, how that should be done, who should do them, and what role standardized tests will have in those evaluations, if any.
Well, having been a teacher for 35 years, how is it going to change from when you were being evaluated in your other career?
You know, I've often said, and I speak to teacher groups all the time, that it was years ago that teachers were put on a pedestal, so to speak. They were honored for the work they did. Of late, and I'm talking over the last 20 years, it seems, that teachers are being attacked, that they're the problem. And it's a terrible thing. They shouldn't be made to be the problem because they're not. They're dedicated individuals. But I think many in the political realm like to use them as foils in their quest to achieve election. And it's terrible. Every executive, be it a mayor or a governor or even a president, has to come out and put out a reform educational package. And quite often those packages fall on the shoulders of attacks on teachers, and it's terrible. So we're going to try to balance that out and make that a little calmer situation for the teachers.
You know, all too frequently people complain about a lack of interaction of parents with the education system, and then on the other hand, sometimes you get an overactive parent base, and they
and it varies
the teachers, and it really does vary.
It varies from district to district, and how that, you know, one of the ways that it has changed enormously from the time when I was in the classroom to where it is now. Email, It seems every teacher gives out an email to the parents so they can communicate. The lines of communication have been expanded, and teachers and parents can talk readily
about... More directly, perhaps.
Absolutely. And that's one of the wonderful things about it. Teachers, the good teachers, I remember, would go home at the end of the day at school, and they would quite often call the parents of some of the children and talk to them about some of the problems that might be happening. Now they do the same thing, but it can be instantaneous by emails, and that's a wonderful thing. And it can be directed individually to each parent and each kid and addressed. And that has opened up a whole new realm since I left.
And we find sometimes, though, in the emailing, you get some confusion. People sometimes don't email necessarily exactly what they mean to be saying, and don't receive the same message. Sometimes face-to-face is far more effective.
It always is face-to-face. You can't inflect your voice. You can't inflect your email.
They can't see that good-looking smile of yours.
There you go. Yes, I paid an awful lot for
these people. I'm sure. But you've got a lot of work to do, and I know you're very excited about it. We want to wish you all the very best this year, and we will be watching with great interest, as everyone will, because as you suggest, education is one of the top two components of the whole budget, so your job is even more important.
You're absolutely right. Every year is a challenge up here in Albany. This is going to be a little bit more of a challenge for me, but it's one that I'm eagerly looking forward to.
Look very excited about it. Hey, really pleased to have you with us here.
Thank you, Leaders. David. It's a pleasure.
We thank you very much. That's Assemblyman Mike Benedetto of the 82nd District in the Bronx. He has got big, broad shoulders to handle all of this education work that he's going to be doing this year, as well as all the rest of his work here in the Assembly. That's the way it's starting off this year in Meet the Leaders and in Albany. I'm David Smith.